ओके, सो जावा अरे, राइट? सो अरे इज वॉट इन जावा? अरे इज लाइक अ होमोजेनस ग्रुप ऑफ एन एलिमेंट. लाइक अरे यू कैन से एज अ कंटेनर, यू कैन से ओके दैट होल्ड्स अ फिक्स नंबर ऑफ वैल्यू दैट आर ऑफ होमोजेनस टाइप. अरे इज कॉल अ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर इन जावा. इट्स अ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर. नाउ वॉट डू यू मीन बाय अ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर? ओके, सो डेटा स्ट्रक्चर इन द सेंस दैट इज यूज टू अरेंज द डेटा, दैट इज यूज टू ऑर्गेनाइज द डेटा. ओके, सो अरे इज वॉट हियर? अरे इज अ होमोजेनस ग्रुप ऑफ एलिमेंट. होमोजेनस इन द सेंस वॉट? सिमिलर काइंड ऑफ. सिमिलर इन द सेंस लाइक इट कैन बी ऑफ इंटीजर टाइप, इट कैन बी ऑफ फ्लोट टाइप, इट कैन बी ऑफ कैरेक्टर टाइप, राइट? सो सिमिलर काइंड ऑफ एलिमेंट वैन यू ग्रुप टूगेदर दे कैन बी सेव इन अ अरे. सो इट इज, यू कैन से इट, इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर वेयर यू अरेंज द डेटा इन सम सिक्वेंस और एंड दैट डेटा शुड बी ऑफ होमोजेनस टाइप. ओके, नाउ एज यू कैन सी ऑन माई स्क्रीन, राइट, यू माइट हैव सीन दिस वन लॉन्ग लेंथ ऑफ सम फॉर्म ऑफ अ सेल, राइट? दिस आर एक्चुअली कॉल अ सेल दैट विल होल्ड अ डेटा. ओके, एंड ईच सेल विल हैव सम इंडेक्स वैल्यू. इंडेक्स वैल्यू इन द सेंस दैट विल हेल्प टू आइडेंटिफाई पर्टिकुलर सेल. ओके, सो नॉर्मली हाउ द अरे इज देयर इन एन अरे इज प्रेजेंट इन ऑल द लैंग्वेजेस, एनी प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज. सो अरे इज फर्स्ट द वी विल सी वॉट इज एन अरे. ओके, द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज वॉट इज एन एरे. ओके, द आंसर इज दैट इट्स अ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर वेयर वी सेव और यू कैन से इट होल्ड्स सिमिलर ग्रुप ऑफ एलिमेंट. सिमिलर ग्रुप ऑफ एलिमेंट इन द सेंस वॉट डू यू मीन बाई दैट? सिमिलर ग्रुप ऑफ एलिमेंट एज आई ऑलरेडी सेड यू having similar properties like similar types, data type, right? If I say you integer, right, then it might be like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They are numeric, right? They are of integer type. If I say you a, b, c, d, right? These are what? Character type, right? So it is used to hold a group of data. Now, why there is a need of array comes in any programming language. Okay, we all know that in Java, how we declare an any variable, we usually suppose in a simple way, very simple way, you declare an any variable like this, right? Int a is equal to 2, right? Right, and it holds only one value at a time, right? It holds only one value. Right? Now, suppose there is a situation when you want to save a number of data, right? How you will going to save? Now, suppose if you try to save data like this, int a equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it will give you an error, right? It can't save the group of data same type inside a single variable. In order to remove this, in order to overcome this situation, the researcher, they are like a James Gosling, or you can say the person who has invented this Java and other, they decided to bring such thing in the programming language or to add something that a single variable can hold a set of value. Okay, so in order to overcome this situation, array come into the market. Here, a single variable can hold group of similar data. And if I write in a more standard term, then you can write it homogeneous data. Is it clear to you? Am I clear? Yes. So a group of a homogeneous data. So how we usually declare an array? You can be declare an array like this, int a square bracket. I will come into what is square bracket, what do you mean by that? And you can specify values like this. Okay. Now here, what do you mean by a? A is an array of an integer type, and this square bracket is what? In this square bracket, you will decide how many value you want to read in an array or you want to enter in the array. For example, suppose you declare an array like this. It means what? You can save three data in this. Means max to max, you can save a three data in this, or you can say minimum one or zero also, right? But here, this three will decide the size of an array, means the number of element present in an array. So what this will going to decide the size of an array. And here you are trying to save 1, 2, 3 in this A. A is what? A is an array. A single name, a single variable name you have given array, okay? Single variable name A. A for this all three data, right? Here you can't, this is not a valid to use in a Java. Not valid, you can't use it. However, in a Python and all, if you use this, it will be valid, but not valid in Java. But in this, with the help of an array, you can save a multiple data. Like here, A is an array where you have saved three data, right? So this is the whole concept of an array. Like why there is a need of an array? It is used to save a homogeneous data. And you can save as much as data possible, right? And one more thing, in case suppose now if you are not sure about this size, suppose you are not sure that how many element you want to read it, or then how you will deal with that? You can simply write A and you leave that size as an empty and you can use it. So as the number you are reading, it will accept all the number because you haven't specify any size here, right? So it means that it's open to accept as many as element. But here, because you have declared as a three, so it can accept max to max three element, right? And some of the Java compiler they will allow you to read beyond more than three element also. But the valid use is you can use it dynamic array. Like where you don't need to specify the size and you can use it. Okay, so this is what the introduction of the array, like how is an array, what is an array, why there is a need of array coming to the market. Now I will show you the way of declaring an array and all. Yeah, one more thing that I wanted to add in this. Now we have declare an array and we have saved three element, but internally in the memory inside your computer system, how it looks. It will be like this. I think I have taken some. It will be like this, where you have a, as you have a three element you have read, it is an array. Then the name internally inside the memory. This is your array A, means the variable name A, which is of a integer type, right? And how the value will going to save here? 1, 2, 3, right? So here in the first cell, 1, 2, 3, right? this is with respect to data, but there might be something you need it to find out in which cell the data are present. Okay, so there is a term called an index that will going to keep the record of the cell. Okay, usually in an array the index start from zero. Okay, so in the zero, one is present, one, two is present, at the two index, three is present, and it will be goes so on, right? So it is inside the computer system, it is in the form of cell, your datas are saved in the form of sequence, and it is a contiguous memory, right? In contiguous sequence, the datas are saved. Contiguous is what? In sequence. So it is also known as a data structure. Contiguous What do you mean by data structure? Data structure means arrangement of data, organization of data, how you can organize the data. Like here, you are organize the data in a sequence, right? Inside this index. So this is called as an array. And as per the standard website for the Java Oracle, you can see here, if suppose if anyone asks you, tell me the element present at an index 8, or index 1 or 0, you can easily find it out. Okay, and what is the size of your array will be always last index plus 1. The size of an array will be the last index plus 1, you can say it. Is it clear to you, right? Is it clear to you? Like,
yes, sir.
Yes, or any question here till now? Anything not clear, any doubt here? So
no
you
doubt.
Can, yes. So here, if anyone asks you like what is the size of an array, so the size of an array will be last index plus one. But if anyone asks you what will be the last index, then it will be size minus one. Means you can find out easily right here. If I say you, okay, like suppose here, if I say you, what is the size of an array here? The size of an array is what here? 10, right? You know this, but how did you find it out? Last index plus 1. Okay, so last index is what here? 9 plus 1, that will become 10. Now if I say you, in case of when you know size equal to 10, suppose I put the question in another way, if I say you the size of an array is 10, then what will be the index value? How you will going to find it out? Just 10 minus 1, that will become 9. In that case, 9 will be your last index. And as you know that index start from 0, so the total number of element will be how much? 0 to 9 will be 10, right? Is it clear? So this, the both are interrelated to each other, right? Means size of an array, if you know, you can find it out the last index. And suppose last index you know, you can find it out the size of an array, and you can easily find it out the element or the data present in on any cell, okay, with the help of this index number. Now let's see this program. Now let me open the Eclipse and explain you this program. So in this program, they are just processing the array element. Okay, so here what they have done, they have read an array. Okay, having a size 10, right? Here you can see the 10. It means that the total element will be 10 and index will be from 0 to 9. Let my Eclipse open, then I will explain you this program. Before coming into the program, let me tell you like how many way you can declare an array. First thing, as I told you, right, you can declare an array simply like as I have shown you in here, simple like int a in a square bracket, you can declare it and you can read it. This is called compile time because you are reading before running the program. Another way of declaring an array is what? This type. This is another way. In Java, you can read an array where same thing is there. Only the thing is that here I am adding this thing, right? So new keyword is what here? New keyword is used to initialize a memory. Means with the help of new keyword, this whole array will get space into the memory. Memory means what here? RAM. And how much memory you want here? You will initialize here 5. Is it clear to you, both of you, like how we can declare an array? This new keyword is what? It will going to initialize a memory.
Yes, sir.
How many number of element?
5.
Correct. So this 5 element will get a space in the memory. Like how it will be? Suppose you have some, this is a RAM, okay? This is your RAM. So inside this memory, you have declared here 5, okay? So 10 will get space in some place, okay? 20 will get space in some place, and 70. So they will get a space in, so they will get a space. So they will get a space in the memory, right? So that is the reason why we use a new keyword. And as they get a space in the memory, we can use it in the way like we can perform a different operation on that. So the new keyword is used. So there are two ways of declaring an array. First thing is you can declare int a and you can initialize a size here only in this square bracket. And in compile time, you can read it like as I have shown you. In this way you can read it. This is a one way of reading an array, okay? This is the first way. Second way, as I have shown you, like how you can read it. The second way will be a square bracket new a and you will initialize this 5. So this is the one another way of reading an array. Now let me run the program and show you. So here we there is a two way of declaring an array, as I said you. So here you can declare in this way, and you can declare this way also, right? This both are same way, same thing. The only difference is that here I have declare int type, so I am directly using the name of array here, and I'm in order to provide the space into the memory, all the element that I'm going to read now, I use it new int 10. Here 10 is what? It will allocate the memory for my 10 integer. You can use as much you can, right? Now I'm initializing all the tail element here, all the 10 element from 0 to 9. It's also depend on you what element you want to save in array. This is as of now compile time. I will tell you in the next class like how you can read the array at a runtime with the help of user. Means user can initialize the value of this element, right? Once you initialize it, you can print it with the help of index, as I told you, right? Means every element will have an index. So what is the array variable here? This n array, right? And you can see when you will going to print n array 0, okay, it will print to you, it will show you the element present at index 0, okay? And here you can see, you as you all already know, like how to declare in class, so I have not explained about this. I'm just telling you the logic about the array, like how you can declare an array and how you can allocate a memory for tail element. Let's run this code and then we can analyze the output. Okay, there is some error saying. What's an error? Okay. There was an extra curly brace, that's why it was giving error. See here. Like, see how the element it is printing present at index 0 to 9, right? So in this way, you can print any element. These are compile based. This program is compile based. What do you mean by compile based? Because you are initializing the value at the time of coding itself. You are not accepting the input from a user. So today I've shown you how you can declare an array, okay? How you can allocate a memory to them, how you can initialize a element index wise. Okay, it depend on you. Let's try with instead of 10, let's try with 15. And in case of 15, index will start from, okay, what will be the last index in that case?
The last index would be 14.
Good. And it will start from 0 to
14.
14, right?
Yeah.
So here, let's declare an array. Now tell me any value for the 10th index. What value you want to save? Any value you tell.
20.
Okay. So similarly, we have to do it for 4 more elements. And their index will be 11, 12, 13, 14, right? And let's take an element like 30, 40, 50, and 60. And I have declared the size 15. It means that here it will be 15 space will be allocated and my last index will be 14. So let's run this code. Okay, sorry. Okay, I have not written here this one. It means that I have read it, but I have not printed it. You need to print also, right? Then only it will be visible on the screen. Here. So do you understand now, like how you can read the element and how you can print it? It will be something, it will also form a cell, and it will having total 15 elements starting from 0 to 14. 0 will be your starting index, 14 will be your last index, and always remember it is a contiguous memory. It's a contiguous data structure. Contiguous in the sense data will be saved in a sequence, as you can in the cell from 0 to 14. So hope it is clear to you what is an array and how you can read a value in compile time. This is a compile time. So in the next session, I will explain you how you can read a value from the user, and we will do some further complex program in the same array. So I will going to share this code with you. Okay, and you can practice this code, and this video also I will upload it in the YouTube. So you can just have a look there if you have any doubt, if not clear. Okay, so is it clear to you, having any doubt? Akshara, Snigdha, anything not clear? Is it clear to you both?
Yes, sir, it's clear. It's clear, okay. Sir.
Yeah, okay. So, okay then. Just practice this code. And we will.